she can see it. Good evening, and welcome to a live performance. Yes, it's so nice to have live performances again. So even in a limited fashion, it's great. I was telling these guys, last time that the junior high band had a live performance was like a year and 3 or 4 months ago. So I'm kind of excited to have live performances again. So the first number we're going to start with is going to be Lone Star March, or not Lone Star March, sorry, Lone Star Overture. If you would, please make sure your your phones are put on. Make sure they're put on silent. You can use them by all means to take pictures and video and that stuff. Would rather you not play games or do those things. And, since the kids work really hard, that'd be kind of rude and not nice to them. So I ask nicely that you not do that. But by all means, you can photograph all you want. You can video all you want. This, I believe, is also going to be live streamed. So, okay? So, Lone Star Overture.
Thank you. variety of music. This is by David Holsinger, and this is called Gypsy Dance.
Thank you.
there's going to be a slight intermission, very slight. I don't know how long it's going to take. At the end here, after our last number, we have to push everything back, and then I want to help. We have to get the riser set up and such with the choir for the second part of the program. We do thank you for being here, and thank the support that parents in band and choir give to their kids. Music is such an important part of their life, and it has a lot of life lessons that can be learned, as well as other very beneficial aspects. So the last number we're going to do is by Robert W. Smith, who writes a lot of great stuff. And this one is called The Tempest, and it's supposed to represent a storm out at sea. This one is The Tempest.
No, I went.
My check.
Thank you. graders. It's called Follow the Dreams and Boards by Rolo Gilmore. Our class enjoyed just calling it Drinking Squash, because explaining what a gourd was a whole other class period. But Cherry Dance, it is usually a travel song that they use with the drinking gourd up in the eye, and it was used for slavery and escaping. So a lot of the times our text that we're listening to tells the story and gives us code words to use for them. Would walk around town singing this song at all of their neighbors as they saw them. And our second song that we have will be Till the Stars Fall from the Sky, which is a very slow love ballad that has different soloists throughout our group coming out and confessing their love for every one of you in the audience tonight.
Thank you.
coming out tonight and supporting our music students once more. Have a great evening and enjoy.
Thank you, everyone, and have a great night.